Okay, so far, what we have done is to draw our network and also change the network properties. So from junctions, links, or pipes to reserve our data. At least for now, this is the network that we have. So the next important thing, again, this is very important, is to optimize our model. Okay, so to optimize our model by using the following parameters. So the first one is velocity. So we need to make sure that our velocity ranging from 0.4 meters per second all the way to at least 1.5 there. But remember, this one's here changing from country to country. But 0.4 to 0.5 all the way to 1.5 meters per second. The second parameter is nothing but the unit head loss. We need to make sure that we maintain the unit head loss to around 5 meters per kilometers all the way to 10, okay, 10 meters per kilometers. And not just that, the other parameter is pressure, okay, pressure, especially at these areas here, okay, so because this is the areas that we assume that the people are going to consume water from these junctions here. So within these areas here, it should be 10 meters of water columns, but not above 20 or 30. Okay, at this point, also this point and this one, not above 30 or 20. So we need to aim around 10 meters of water columns, but not above 20. So from here, what you can do is to run our model again. Remember, you need to validate first and then run your model. Okay, so this is what. So if I click any of the link here, there is something here that you can notice. So if I double click this, you can see we have these calculated values here. If I go here, you can see these are the results. So if I click this, you can see these are the results. So this is the flow velocity, head loss gradient, and also head loss. Okay, so these are the calculated values, but the most important here is velocity. So first one is velocity. So if you can see, we have 0.18 meters per second. Remember, as I said, we need to aim for the minimum velocity of 0.4 to 0.5 all the way to 1.5 meters per second. But for now, it seems as though we have the lowest value of velocity. So if this is the value of velocity that we have, which is 0.18, and it is quite small, so this suggests a few things. So the first one is we have very little amount of head losses, because if you can check here, the pipe diameter here is quite big compared to the flow that we want to carry with our pipe. So the only thing here that we can do is to find a mechanism to increase head losses and hence to increase our velocity. And the best way you can do that is to reduce the pipe diameter. Okay, so from here, I need to click this, and if you can see, we have now 152. I need to reduce this pipe diameter so as I can increase head losses in my pipe and hence to increase the velocity. So with that, let me start. So if for now this is the value that I have, let me take it down to 1110. Remember, the pipe diameter that you are going to use at this area here is, it's not the commercial diameter or the outside diameter. Make sure that you are using the inside diameter of the pipe. That is very important. So for now, I'll just select this and check velocity if is increased. Okay, so let me close this. Let me run. If I double click this pipe, before we had 0.8, let me check now. You can see now the velocity has increased from 0.18 to 0.34. Okay, so why? Because we reduced the pipe diameter as a way of increasing head losses within the pipe, hence to increase the velocity. Again, this is not quite there yet. What I can do is to reduce again the pipe diameter. So from 110 mm dia pipe. The next lowest pipe is 90 millimeter mm. I'll just close this and run again, and then I'll check the velocity. So if I double click again, you can see for now, velocity is 0.5. Okay, remember, we needed to find a way to increase head losses in our pipe so as we can increase the velocity, the water velocity. And the only way we could do that is by reducing the pipe diameter. So from 152 all the way to 90, and hence the velocity has increased from 0.18 to 0.5. But what if we have a way of displaying our result value instead of double clicking each link and find and check here at the calculated values? This is the thing that I want to cover next. So let me close this. I need to find a way to display my results at my network here. So what we can do is to go at this area here. You can see we have element and the symbology. I'll just select a pipe. Okay, if I click this plus value, you can see we have, by default, we have this label. So if I close this label, you can see now we don't have pipe label. If I open again, you can see we have the pipe label. So let me close this first, and let me right click this pipe here. Let me right click it and select new annotation. Okay, so this window here is going to appear. What I need to do is to select here at field name, of course at this area, you can see this, and go straight to the results. Remember, we want to display the velocity because for now we are working on velocity. Let me display velocity here. Okay, so from here, if I click apply, let me move this. If I click apply, you can see we have the numbers here. Let me find a way to at least shift them a little bit to make them visible. From here, what I can do is to select this initial offset. Remember, we have this X offset and Y offset. X offset and the Y offset. If I draw like X and Y axis, you can see if I change the X values, we are not going to have a good results. Instead, what I need to do is to change the Y value. Of course, to make sure that we move our results in Y direction. So with that, if I move this and I need to select, I'll just maintain the X value as zero, but I'll need to offset my values to a Y direction, let's say with 2 units. And then click apply. Let me see if I click apply, if these values here will just move up or down. Of course, because this is a positive value, then I expect my values here to move up. Okay, so this is what we have. At least this is this looks good. So for now, I'll just click OK. So this is what we have for now. So instead of just clicking one link after another and try to see what is the velocity, I don't know what is what, that is not good. What we did is to introduce this annotation, which is a velocity annotation, and this is what we have. So we are going to close this. I don't want label for now. I'll just make sure that I turn on this velocity annotation. That is very important. And so for now, what I can do is to continue optimizing our model. Okay, remember, when you are optimizing your model, start from the first pipe. For my case, the first pipe was this one, because this is the source, then this is the first one. You don't need to start with these ones here. It's not a good practice. Always start with this first pipe here. So this one here, it's done, because for now we have like 0.5 meters per second. What we can do is to also change this one, because for now we have the same value, which is 0.18. So what I can do, because here we have this pipe diameter, because here we have this 90, let me adapt the same value, which is 90. So from 152, let me adapt 90. Okay, adapt 90, then click run. Let me see if this value here is going to change. Okay, so as you can see now we have 0.5. By the way, if you get anything out of this tutorial, don't forget to click that like button, at least to make sure that you help the YouTube algorithm to suggest this video to more people like you. Okay, so from here I need to change of course the same here. Let me adapt the same value, which is 90, and also let me run. Okay, so at least for now this is what we have, and from here what I can do is to change these values here. Okay, but before that, let me introduce another annotation. I need to display the flow or discharge, flow results. Let me select the flow. And again, what I can do here is to click apply. But if you can see, it is not look good. Let me select here and also apply, because I want it to move downwards. Let me apply -2 offset on y direction. So this is what we have again. So we have this and this one. Okay, so from here, remember this link here is carrying like 1 liters per second. At least I need to change this again and see. Remember, we only have 1 liters per second, but the pipe diameter by default is 152. Okay, so I need to reduce the pipe size so as I can increase head losses within the pipe, and hence to increase the water velocity within the pipe. So from here, I need to reduce the pipe diameter from, let's say, 90, and see what I have in this region. Let me click run. At least for now, we are having 0.16. But that is not what we want, because it is below even the minimum required velocity value, which is 0.5 or 0.4. So let me reduce again the pipe. Let me reduce again the pipe from 90. So the next lowest pipe diameter is 75. At least now we have 0.2. Let me double click it again. The next one is 63. But it's not there yet. Is 15. Remember, you need to use the internal diameter. The internal diameter, that's very important. At least for now, this is the result that we have. The next one here is this. Let me adapt the same, 50, and also, okay, so if I apply 60, then at least velocity, this is the velocity value that we have. And again, at this branch here, I need also to change the value. Let me start with 75. So what I'm doing here is to find a pipe diameter that is going to give me the velocity value that I want. Let me start with 75, and also this one 50. Let me adapt here 50 mm, and also I need to adapt on this region here the same value, which is 50. So from here, let me run and see what I have. Okay, so if you can see, the flow here is 2.2 liters per second. Of course, this 2.2 is the summation of the base demand that we assign these junctions. So here it is 2.2, and also here we have 0.6 and 0.51, which again, both of them are within the acceptable velocity range, which is 0.4 to 0.5 all the way to 1.5 meters per second.